What I really want to do is get a closer look at the technology. I may get a few ideas myself.
So you want to find out more about hearing aids?
Yes, please. I've seen people wearing them, but I don't really know how they work.
Hallux's Hearing Help Desk.
Oh, I do love a good gadget. It's been fascinating learning about hearing. However, what I really want to do is get a closer look at the technology. I may get a few ideas myself.
So you want to find out more about hearing aids?
Yes, please. I've seen people wearing them, but I don't really know how they work.
Well, as we know, hearing aids help people with hearing loss. Their job is to collect the sounds all around, make them louder and clearer, and then deliver the sounds into the ear. Check it out on my screen. Some hearing aids are called BTE and others are called ITE. Any idea what they stand for? Maybe it will help if you see how they're worn.
Aha! BTE stands for behind the ear and ITE for in the ear.
You've got it! Which type you have will be down to preference. Younger children quite often have the sort behind the ear, which come in a great range of cool colours. Older children might have the in-the-ear version, which as you can see are much smaller and fit snugly in the ear.
You can hardly see it!
Now, if someone has a more severe hearing problem, they might use a device called a cochlear implant. This is a very tiny piece of electronic equipment that's put into the cochlear during an operation. It helps the damaged or destroyed hairs by turning sounds into electrical messages that stimulate the hearing parts of your brain directly. In order for someone to hear with a cochlear implant, they have to wear a speech processor, which looks a bit like a hearing aid. In order for a child to have a cochlear implant, they need to be at least 1 year old, have severe or profound hearing loss in both ears, and are unable to hear well with their hearing aids. Cochlear implants can also be used with Roger systems.
Roger? Who's Roger when he's at home?
It's the name of the gadget, not a person. Check it out. If you have hearing loss, it can be particularly hard to work out who's talking in a crowd or to understand what's being said when the speaker is a long way from you, like the teacher at the front of a class. Luckily, Roger's here to help. Roger systems have two parts. One part is a little wireless microphone which is worn by the person speaking.
Okay, class, today we're going to.
When someone has a Roger system, they hear the talker's words clearly and directly in their hearing aids, making it easier to hear in noise.
Well, that sounds like a great idea for school, or if you're playing sport, you'd be able to hear the coach shouting at you.
Sarah, keep your eyes on the ball!
Or your mum cheering you on. And it looks like they come in lots of different shapes and sizes. Lots of different Rogers.
Yep, there are pen microphones, microphones that you can wear on your shirt, ones that you can place on a table, all sorts.
Roger that. It's terrific to know that all levels of hearing loss can be helped by modern technology.
Although it pays to look after your hearing, maybe you should invest in some earplugs the next time you go swimming, Professor. This could stop you getting an earful of water.
Hang on, wait a minute. Yes, I do believe my ears just popped, Nurse. Yes, everything sounds so much clearer now.
Thank goodness for that.
Thank goodness for cats.
Professor!
Only joking.
Hallux's Hearing Help Desk. Find out more about your ears and hearing at phonak.com.